गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट बुक, दैट इज द विस्टास एंड द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द विस्टास इज द एनिमी. द एनिमी चैप्टर इज रिटन बाय पर्ल एस बक एंड दिस चैप्टर वाज रिटन एट दैट टाइम व्हेन द वॉर वाज हेल्डिंग between America and Japan. Both of them, means America and Japan, were great enemy to each other as the world war was heading. Okay, what is the theme of the chapter? Humanity requires one to overcome prejudices and hatred, especially against one's enemies. Very great philosophy is given by the writer in this chapter. When you will go through the chapter, then you will find out that the main character is in the starting in dilemma, in the condition of dilemma, what is to be done. But he has come to the conclusion and he has given the importance to duty. Let us find out. So what is the theme of the chapter, the enemy? The theme of the chapter is humanity requires to overcome prejudices. Prejudices means in Hindi, jo aap purvagraho se grasit hote hain. Prejudices and hatred especially against one's enemy. Obviously, we the people know that we always hate from our enemy. No. This chapter is telling that there is no need of hatred, especially from our enemies. Okay, and we should try to overcome all the prejudices. What is the background? This chapter was set at the time of World War. Already I have explained, this chapter was set at the time of World War. Main characters of this chapter. First main character is Dr. Sadao. Dr. Sadao is a Japanese doctor. He is a dedicated surgeon. Not only surgeon, but also scientist. Why I am saying scientist? Because this doctor has discovered some medicine which rendered the wound. So I am calling him surgeon as well as a scientist. Kind, obviously, he is a kind fellow. Prejudice against the white enemy. In the starting, you will see that he is having prejudice against the white enemy, white man. Hannah is the wife of Dr. Sadao. A balanced woman. Hannah is a balanced woman and stands always with her husband. And Hannah is always standing with her husband in every situation. She is a responsible lady. She is dignified and graceful. General, selfish and careless. General is a selfish fellow, careless fellow. Tom is a prisoner of war. But this man is having a strong will. Means Tom is having a strong will. Okay? And the next character is Yumi. Yumi is the maid. Or in other words, you can say nurse. Yumi is the nurse in the house of Dr. Sadao. She looks after the children of Dr. Sadao and Hannah. Once again, I am coming to the characters. Okay. Dr. Sadao is a Japanese doctor. But he has got his medical degree in America. When he was 22 years old, his father, who was totally worried, who was too much worried about the education of his only son. This is the reason that when he was 22 years old, he was sent to America for the study of the medical science. Okay, and he returned from there after 8 years, when he became 30 years old, and there he has learned all about the medicine, okay, and about the medical science, okay. And Hannah is the wife of Dr. Sadao. Hannah and Dr. Sadao has met in America in the house of professor. Okay. And both of them were falling in love with each other, but they have first given importance to their career. Okay. And Sadao informed about this to his father. When Dr. Sadao and Hannah finished their study and they returned to Japan, and when Sadao father confirmed that she is pure in his race, then the marriage was made in old Japanese style. Okay. And when the story is starting, you will find that they are having two sons. General was badly wounded in the battlefield, and he was under the care of Dr. Sadao. Every doctor was sent with the troop of soldiers, with the troop of army. Every doctor of Japan was sent with the troop of army, because they have to do the treatment of the army person or the soldiers when they were wounded. Okay. But Dr. Sadao was kept in Japan. Why was he kept in Japan? Because General was in an ardent need of Dr. Sadao, and he was having a blind faith on Dr. Sadao. This is the reason that Dr. Sadao was not sent with the troop. Okay. Tom is an American soldier. Tom is a prisoner of war. Okay. And in other words, he was in U.S. Navy. It was written on the uniform which he was having at that time when he came by the doorstep of Dr. Sadao. By the babes. Okay. Yumi is the nurse. She is looking after the children of Dr. Sadao and Hannah. Very emotional girl. And some servants. As you know, he is a famous servant. Obviously, there were many servants. Cook, gardener, so many servants. And all these servants were thinking that our master should be loyal to the country. Okay. And this all the servants were having the feeling of prejudices. Okay, guys, let us start the story. Dr. Sadao was standing on the veranda, and the house of Dr. Sadao was on the verge of the sea, on the edge of the sea, on the bank of the sea, or you can say on the edge of the sea, on the verge of the sea. Okay. So the house of Dr. Sadao was situated, built, you can say, on a verge of a sea. sea of south coast or on the south coast sea. Okay. One day, Dr. Rao was standing on veranda. He was seeing towards the sea. The mist was rising from the sea. And he was thinking about Haina, and Haina came and put her arms round the neck of Dr. Sadhguru. Although they were having two children, but they were having a great affection to each other. They were looking towards the sea. Both of them were looking towards the sea. They saw something mist. They saw something mist like human, like a man, and that mist was like a man. Dr. Sadhguru guessed that perhaps he is a fisherman who has fallen from the boat. Okay, the man was coming, and all of a sudden he fell by the face and started kneeling, and the man started kneeling, and Dr. Sadhguru ran towards the man. Okay, Dr. Sadhguru ran towards the man, and Haina followed him. And when Dr. Sadhguru came near the man, he found that the man was wounded by the bullet. And the bullet was at his backside. Why the bullet was at backside? Because he has tried to escape. This is the reason that he was having bullet at the backside. Being a doctor, he started searching out the wound and touched the wound. A fresh blood started coming. Then after Dr. Sadhguru covered the wound by the sea moss in Hindi, kai, sea moss. Okay, sea moss. He covered the wound by the sea moss. And when the man was turned, because he was lying by the face, and when he was turned, both of them get surprised because they come to know that he was a white man, and it was confirmed by his uniform that he was from US Navy. And at that time, America and Japan were in war. World War was held in. What is to be done? That was the question before them. Okay. And Haina said that let us throw the man again in the water. Okay. But being a doctor, it was difficult for Dr. Sadhguru to throw the man into the water. He was not bothering that whether he is enemy, friend or what. But at this time, he was in pain. He wanted treatment, and the Dr. Sadhguru wanted to do that. Okay? But there was one more question. If I am going to give the shelter to this man in my house, I will be arrested by the police as being disloyal to the country. So he could not understand what is to be done. He was in the condition of mental dilemma. As a result, you can see there is a conflict between duty and loyalty to the country, and duty has won. Because a doctor whose all skill is to save a dying man, how can it possible that he will let him die? No, he will not let this man die. So this man was carried by Dr. Sadhguru and his wife Haina. And they carried the man to the room of his father. To the room of his father, that room was vacant. That room was empty. Now, why this room was empty? Because Dr. Sadao's father has already died. Okay? And this room was empty. All the things which was kept in that room was of Japanese style. Was made of Japan. Okay? So, Dr. Sadao and Hannah brought the man into the room of his father, and the room was totally empty as the father was already dead. And all the things which was kept in the room was made of Japan. Means to say that man likes his things. He has not sat on a foreign chair, not slept in foreign bed. Okay, by the way, and the man was very dirty. There was need of washing soap. So Dr. Sadao asked his wife to go and bring some hot water and wash the man because he was dirty, but she has forbidden. No, I am not going to wash this man because he is a white man and she disliked the white man. Okay, she disliked the white man, or you can say she did not want to touch him. So she said that I am going to inform Yumi. Doctor said that you are going to inform Yumi. I will tell others. All the person will come to know about this fact that we have given shelter to a white man. You have to do this work. Yumi was called and she was asked to bring some hot water. She bought the hot water, but she has refused to wash. And Hannah made her clear that, yaar, we only want to cure this man. We only want to bring this man incense. After that, we will hand over him to the police. But Yumi said, I am servant. I am a poor lady. I am not having anything from this. This is your business, but I am not going to wash this man. Hannah herself washed the man. And Dr. Sadao came and he was having his medical instrument, which was needed for an operation, because there was a need of an operation as the bullet was in the body. Till now, bullet was in the body, and he has put the bullet out from his body and cured him, injected him, and day by day the white man was getting stronger. The food, breakfast. Everything was given by Hannah. Because Yumi has already forbidden that no, I am not going to wash this man. So everything was done by Hannah and the man was successfully treated. The bullet was made out of his body and day by day he was recovering. He was getting well. Okay. And one day when the servants came to know about the fact that our master has given shelter to a white man, then all of them opposed of it and said Hannah that our master should not treat him. He should hand over this white man to the police. Okay. And Hannah told that I will tell to your master. But next day all the servants packed their luggage and they wanted to leave their job. They left the job. Next day no work was done. Dr. Sadao and Hannah understood that the servants had gone. Yumi also had gone. All the servants had gone. Okay? And Dr. Sadao was sitting in his library. He was doing something. Then a messenger in uniform came at the gate of Dr. Sadao. And Hannah was in the kitchen. She was doing nothing. She saw the messenger. And the messenger asked about the Dr. Sadao. She get afraid. Why she get afraid? Because she thought The servants had gone. Perhaps they had informed to the police. This is the reason that the police had come to arrest my husband. What is going to happen to me and my two children when my husband is when my husband will go to jail, will send to jail? What will happen to me? Okay, and my children. Okay, see, pointed out towards the library. The man came and he saluted to Dr. Sarao and said that general is again in pain and he has called you. Okay, he has called you. Dr. Sarao went to general. General was in great pain and Dr. Sarao checked him and said that, Excellency, you can bear out one more attack. Okay, you can bear out one more attack. You have already two attacks. In third attack, there is chance of your death. But I will cure you. I will cure you before the third attack. But sir, there is a problem. One day, a prisoner of war washed ashore at my doorstep by the waves. And I have successfully treated him. And my wife wants that this man should not remain in our house for a long time. And sir, I have told you, please do something. General promised that I will send my private assassins, my private murderer. They will kill him inside your house and they will remove the body. But you have to let the back side, the garden side door of that prisoner of war to open. Let it to be open. And my private assassins will go, my private murderer will go and they will kill the man and remove the body from there. And your wife will not come to know. Dr. Sarao came to his house, but he has not said anything to his wife. Early in the morning, he went into the room, but found that the white man was sleeping peacefully. Okay? He thought that maybe today, next night, maybe the murderer will come, next night. But he waited. Second night, today the wind was blowing very fast and it was drizzling. And there was a sound, opening and closing of the door in the room of the prisoner of war. So Hannah got up and he wanted to close the door, but doctor said, no, you have no need to go there because he is now too good and he can close his door. So he forbade his wife. His wife said that I am seeing some changes in your behavior. What is the reason? And whenever there was any sound of the pebbles, Dr. Sarao got up and thought that perhaps they have come. And again, early in the morning, he wanted to get any chance to go into the room of the prisoner of war, but found that he was there. Next day, he went to his office. Three days, Dr. Sarao waited. And he decided that, no, I cannot wait anymore. So, next day, he went to his office. He typed a letter in which he has written all this incident, that one night a prisoner of war was washed ashore by the waves at my doorstep and he was successfully treated by me. And this. So many things he has written. No, he has not completed his letter. He has half finished his letter and then after went from there and he managed that he thought that I will make this man run from my house. I will make this man escape from my house. So he managed a boat and some food, some water to drink him, and gave him his own torch and said that there is an island, you have to row there by himself and you have to wait for the Korean boat, because sometimes the Korean boat came for fishing. Okay, and suppose that your food finished, run dried, you became out of food, then you have to catch the fish and you have to eat it raw. And don't give me signal when it is getting dark. Give me two signal, it means that you are there, and give me one signal, it means that you are safe. Okay, you are safe. Okay, and Dr. Sadao checked his temperature and everything. Okay, temperature was high. Why it was high? Because of the excitement. And the man rowed the boat, reached on the island, and Dr. Sadao saw a flash of light, and he came to know that his patient, or you can say the white man, was safe and he had gone. There are so many burning questions which are standing before us. Was it good? What was done by doctor? What is the reason that he has not thought about his country? What is the reason that he was not loyal to his country? Why he has given importance to his duty? So many burning questions we will discuss, guys, in our next lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.